Hello, and back to the build stage where it's at. How many of you are C-sharp devs? Hands. Oh, a lot of you nerds. Good, I like that. I like this for you. So we have very good news for you C-sharp nerds, because today we've got Luce, who's an expert from MongoDB, talking to us about the beautiful intersection of MongoDB and C-sharp.
Absolutely.
Tell us.
Yeah, so one of the things we announced recently was a new provider for Entity Framework Core with MongoDB, okay. And developers are really excited about it, so I'm excited that I can come and tell you all about it. So it kind of started off a couple of years ago, so obviously Entity Framework is the most popular like ORM for databases. I think I saw a stat that 39% of .NET developers use Entity Framework.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, so, and then I think something like 50% of developers who've not used MongoDB before want to use it. And so when the opportunity kind of came about to do a partnership to create a provider for it, it's something that had been asked for a long time, and so the team jumped at it. So we had engineers from the both sides, from Microsoft Entity Framework team, and also actually we had a contractor come in with our engineering team who used to work on the Entity Framework team, which is super cool. So that collaboration was there, and they were just learning from each other, and so that was great. And then in November, I think it was, we released preview one of the provider, and then it went GA a couple of weeks ago, and we actually had the wonderful and infamous Jeff Fritz coming up to our event in New York to tell people about it, which was super cool.
Hi, Jeff Fritz. We're talking about you again.
We love you.
We love you. Okay, so one thing, I fit in that demographic, right? Okay. I'm a .NET dev. I want to use MongoDB, but I don't know which scenario to use it for, and I think that is the key, right, is to make it super, super clear what to use it for, but also how to use it.
Yeah, so I mean, there's different ways you can get started. Obviously, with the provider, it's really simple. So, like, you just use a DB context like you would before.
Right. Correct.
So, if you're used to Entity Framework, it's nothing new. You use a DB context, you have DB sets just like before.
Yep.
The only thing different might be in the model. So, it looks almost identical.
Yep.
The only things that are different are you can add an attribute to tell it rather than what table to use, what collection to use.
Yeah.
And then here we have our special object ID, which is a data type for our essentially primary key. But one of the cool things as well is that a lot of developers, you know, you might want to use string, right?
Yes,
that's what you're used
to.
You've got methods, and that's what you love. So what's really awesome is that we, as of GA, we release converters. So you can say it has a conversion for object ID.
I like
so you
that.
Can treat it as a string.
Yeah, you can just act like it's a string, but all of this happens automatically by the magic of MongoDB. I don't have to
think
about this. I don't have to learn the syntax. This is great news.
Yeah.
I love not learning new syntax.
Oh, yeah. Well, this is the thing, isn't it? Like, Entity Framework, you don't need a whole new mental model. Or you don't want to learn a whole new mental model.
I don't.
So having the provider means that you don't need to learn the C-sharp driver APIs.
Right.
Like, it's an awesome driver. Don't get me wrong.
Sure,
everyone should try it. But
if you are not used to it, you don't feel like learning it because you have things to do.
Yeah. And even the model itself is, like, super easy. So, like, you just got the add the context like you would normally, but instead of doing something like use SQL Server, you just use MongoDB, you just pass it your connection string, essentially, and then the name
like
of the database, and it just works.
That's really straightforward, shockingly so.
Yeah, well, this is...
Applause.
Yeah, thank you.
Louder.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
Don't you... isn't it cool when it's actually two lines of code? When people are like, oh, you can do it in two lines of code, and it's actually two lines of code?
Yeah, well, this is
That's
what I
weird.
Love.
Even I didn't know this. By the way, this is the first time I learned this information, so this is why you're getting such enthusiasm. Sorry.
I love it. You were
showing me something, and I'm like, ah.
Oh, no, be my guest. You know, you can be enthusiastic with me about it any time you want.
Very enthusiastic. Thank you. Yeah.
But it's super cool, and, like, there's other things as well, so, like... if you do log to, again, that comes from Entity Frameworks. If you just log it to somewhere, I'm being a bit basic and just doing it to console.WriteLine.
Basic is how you start.
Yeah. But if you just do console.WriteLine, it will then actually do some really cool stuff around, like, showing you what queries were run.
Yeah.
So, say you don't know MongoDB, right? You're new to it.
I am new to it, completely.
By having this, amongst all the things you're going to see printed out in the log, you'll also see things like exactly what query was run.
Yes.
So you can learn from it.
I love that.
But you can also,
so it's like teaching you while you're doing this.
Yeah, yeah. But
really
also,
cool.
It's great to learn what was going on under the hood.
Yeah.
But also, it's brilliant because it's helping you identify maybe what those fields you want to index.
Right.
Like, performance is important, right? Everyone cares about it. So maybe you want to index some fields. So this might help you identify things, because this query is actually one of the most simple. It's just doing a match on one thing.
Exactly.
So essentially the equivalent of get by ID.
I love
but
it.
But it's super simple.
So we're, of course, going to run out of time. But is there homework you have for the audience?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have a nice short link here and a QR code you
can
scan.
Do the QR code.
Because everyone loves that.
Code. Yeah.
That will take you to a GitHub gist because, you know, again, keep it simple.
Yes,
right?
Keep it simple.
It has loads of really useful links in there.
Go to the repo, do the thing.
Yeah, there's tutorials you can follow, like articles I've written on how to get started, and it's awesome.
Consume Luce's content, go forth, do the thing, use mongodb.net devs.